Hello, in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your Google Ads ad groups for your campaign. Hello, my name is Jose and thanks for joining in. In this video, I'm going to go through how to set up your ad groups for your campaigns in Google Ads. But before I do that, I'd just like to say that we go live on YouTube every weekday at 4 o'clock in the UK. If you are struggling with Google Ads or digital marketing and need some help or advice, then by all means, please join in. It's free to attend and ask me any questions you may have, and I'll try my best to answer them for you. For you to be notified whenever we go live, just hit the subscribe button and the bell button, and you'll be the first one to know when we go live. And we also upload other videos regularly on YouTube as well, so you will get the notifications those as well. Okay, so following on from my video of how to create the Google Ads campaign, the link for that is in the description. We are now at the stage of setting up our ad groups or ad group. As you can see on the screen, there are four steps. First one is create your campaign. Second one is set up your ad groups. Then you write your ads. And then it goes to review to Google for the ads to be approved. And once they are approved, the campaign goes live. So over here in the ad group section, when we are setting this up, the first option you have is standard or dynamic. Dynamic search ads are completely different. You don't want to do that if you are just running a standard Google Ads search campaign. So keep to standard for the time being. I'm going to go through the dynamic search ads, as how to set those up and why you should be using them, because they are a great way to put your ads in front of your target audience. Then we name your ad group. Now, don't name the ad group as ad group 1, ad group 2, ad group 3, and so on, because you won't know what that ad group is about. So let's say if this ad group is about Google Ads, then I'm going to put this up as Google Ads. I will then put up my default bid. Now, you can bid at ad group level as well as keyword level. So if you are running your ads at bidding at keyword level, then you put them the bids at the keyword level, but for the time being, I'm going to just put in a number. Really doesn't. And then all you do is you will find that Google has pre-populated some of the keywords. Now, if they are not relevant, then all you do is remove them. And what you want to do is then put in Google Ads as my keyword, get keywords is going to give me fair few. Now, be extremely careful as to how many keywords you put in the ad group, because you want to keep them very similar and very relevant. So I'm just going to see what it is. Google Ads. You see, Google advertisement is completely different to Google Ads or AdWords and so on. I don't like all of these, so I'm going to delete all of them and put in Google Ads. Google Ads agency. Google Ad Expert, and so on, and keywords like these. Now, just under this box, you have got these couple of lines where Google is saying that there are different types of match types. Now, I'm not going to go into great detail as to what you, which ones you should be using, but what we do is we quickly go to the Google Support Center. And I'll go through the various match types. So in here, What they haven't given you is the broad modifier. I'm not sure why they don't, they never do, but they've got broad match, race match, and exact match. And these are the ones which you've got over here. Broad modifier, race, exact. So on here, you can click on that link and go through as to how and when your broad match keyword will trigger your ad and the exact match and so on. So there's a very comprehensive page over here, and there's got more information about broad match, phrase, exact, and broad match modifier. Now what I would do is I would never run with broad. I'm going to put in exact. As it says, shows over here, the square brackets are these exact match keywords. You put in a handful of keywords. You can also put in a phrase match as well in the same ad group if you like. So you, all you do is the phrase match is that Google Ads agency last Google Ads expert, and then you can see which one is performing better or worse. You can even put in all three, as this is my broad match modifier. You put in a plus sign in front of each word, but there should not be a and space between the plus sign and the first and the letter, the next letter. Once I've done these, I can either create a new ad group or continue. And now I've created my ad group. The next stage is to go on and write our ads. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please do click the subscribe and the bell button, as you'll be the first one to be notified when we upload other videos and when we do go live on YouTube. So thanks for being with me today. I truly appreciate your time with me, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Bye for now.